When it comes to real estate, everything matters. Whether you're a realtor, homeowner, buyer, or seller, Real Estate Matters with Stuart Title is here to inform, entertain, and inspire you. Host Bill Napick from Stuart Title will talk with guests about what really matters when it comes to owning, buying, and selling real estate. Real Estate Matters with Stuart Title starts right now. Here's your host, Bill Napick.
And welcome to the show, Real Estate Matters with Stuart Title. I am your host, Bill Napick, hosting the show and developing business sometimes at the same time. And today, we are in Tomball, Texas at the beautiful Stuart Title office. Thanks to Sandy Reese for hosting us here and collecting such great guests right here. So this is where America tunes in to hear great real estate talk, lifestyle talk. So whether you are listening in Houston, Texas, Tomball, Texas, Washington, D.C., or anywhere else, we think you're going to enjoy the show because we always have interesting people, and they are here with us today. First, we have Casey Paulson. He is with Blue Jack National. He is the president of that company. Casey, welcome to the show.
Bill, thanks very much for having us. Excited to talk about Blue Jack and what we're doing up there today.
Very nice. Also, first of all, let's tell people, what is Blue Jack National?
Yes, Blue Jack National is a luxury community being developed about an hour north of downtown Houston, about 30 minutes north of the Woodlands area. We focus on world-class amenities, luxury amenities. We focus on the service that it takes to deliver those amenities, and we're fortunate to have a piece of property that is really unique for Texas and even for Houston, with pretty incredible geography and terrain and some wonderful tree canopy that really makes it special.
And also in that area of the Houston area, north of Houston, that is, there is some beautiful land to even start with. As a developer, you're already having a head start, it would seem.
Absolutely. I mean, I think one of our biggest, I guess I'd call it a challenge. It wasn't a challenge, but was just not to mess anything up. You know, the canvas was so good already. From a golf course standpoint, we moved very little earth at all. There's about 150 feet of elevation change throughout the property, which is really wonderful for Texas. And then again, a mature pine canopy, a mature oak canopy, just wonderful topography, certainly for golf and certainly for development. Allows us to do a lot of different things with the different products that we offer, and it'll create really some special places for people to build their dream home.
Also, a development, Casey, has so many components to it. Give us an idea, and you mentioned golf, but give us an idea of some of the other components that are involved in this development.
Well, a huge amount. I mean, you ultimately have about 250 estate lots. You've got about 150 built product type resort lots, and then the full amenity package to use for that. So you'll have clubhouses, you'll have a spa, you have the golf courses you mentioned. Got a really cool little 10-hole golf course called the Playgrounds, which is a wonderful place where kids will be able to learn how to play golf and adults and as well, which will be cool. So we recently started construction on a thing called the Fort, which is kind of the coolest kids amenity that you can imagine. It's got a barn and a bowling alley and a pool and the football field and zip lines and tree houses and all the things that not everybody has growing up. So it's got some cool things. So we're all about family. We're all about fun. We're all about providing service that makes people feel like they're on vacation when they're at home.
It sounds awesome. In fact, I'm ready to go right now. I'm also thinking I need a break, and that sounds like a great place to live. And having the idea wherever we live, to have an idea where it's kind of like a resort, that just sets the mind at ease when you come home from work or even having a great weekend. So it sounds like you've really taken great care into putting all these things together. Also, you're painting such a beautiful picture. Continue to paint that, if you will, and give us another. I'm seeing trees, the golf course, children, families, all having a great time. Tell us more about this development.
Well, I think that it's, one of our biggest focuses is nowadays time is really our most precious commodity that we have. And so everything we've tried to design, everything that we're trying to do is trying to preserve that commodity and have people be willing to have multiple experiences in a short amount of time so that they can do more things with their family. We try and take some of the woes of life, things like dry cleaning and pet care and different things. We try and do some of that for folks so they enjoy that. And then taking all that and making sure that it blends within the community. You know, we've chosen a very tight amount of builders to represent our community. No one more important than Ted and Yvonne, who we're going to talk to here in a few minutes, and really have them embrace what we're trying to do also. You know, we're trying not to clear-cut trees. We're trying to have people preserve the environment that already exists as much as possible. We're very trying to be very responsive that the setbacks from golf course to homes are there's a significant amount of space in there, so the golf doesn't feel like it's right on the house, and the house doesn't feel like it's right on golf, and really trying to be very sensitive. We take a painstaking amount of time at times in making all those decisions, and the smallest level of detail is where we're kind of searching for and trying to do, and we partnered ourselves with people who are in the same mindset, and so every single detail matters at the end of the market that we're trying to hit, and it's all very, very important.
And let's tell people, you mentioned it was north of the Woodlands, if I recall. Tell us how would you get there? Is it would the main highway be 45? Paint a picture of how we're going to get to the development.
Sure. So we are. There's a couple ways to go. You could come up I-45 and then take 105. Out towards Montgomery. We're kind of in the Montgomery Magnolia kind of sweet spot there, kind of in the middle. 249 located here close to where we're at right now is another way that you would get there. And the improvements that you'll see over the Aggie Expressway in the next 2.5-3 years will make access to Blue Jack even easier, because there'll be the main entrance is about the main highway entrance would be about 3 miles south of our main entrance, and so those are the two main ways. Half an hour north of the Woodlands, and then you're only 45 minutes south of College Station as well, so it's getting more and more accessible every day.
And let's tell people, as they may be those that are by the computer right now, what is the website they can go to, and what would they see when they go on the website?
Sure, bluejacknational.com, and they'll see the full complement of what the community is there to offer. Some beautiful pictures, get you a feel for what the terrain looks like. Again, there's a lot of several natural lakes on property, big size, and really, again, just beautiful topography. And I've tried to restore what was already there. I mean, it's a pretty place, and our goal is just not to, again, like I said earlier, not to mess it up.
BlueJackNational.com, easy to remember. Also, if people go and visit the development right now, is it up and running and ready to go, or
yeah,
what's the status?
We've opened up various pieces over the last year and a half or so. We started moving dirt in the development in June of 2014. It feels like it was last week, but it was a couple years ago. We opened up the 18-hole golf course in April of this year, and had our golf course designer, Tiger Woods, out there to help commemorate it, and it hit a few shots for us all to see. And so now we're in the middle of running it and operating it and developing it. And as I mentioned earlier, the fort is our next amenity that's currently under construction, which is just for a family amenity is about as cool as anything I've ever done.
And you mentioned Tiger Woods was there. I bet people love seeing him there on the golf course. Describe a little bit of that.
It was awesome. You know, we've had two really kind of key moments that I'll address kind of quickly. We opened up our 10-hole golf course in March of 2016, and on that day Tiger was out there as well, and we had a little kid from Corpus Christi, a kid named Taylor Crozier, who went ahead and made a hole in one in front of Tiger Woods, and
and
4+ million YouTube follower views later, it became a real kind of a viral hit. Tiger's reaction was just priceless, but the video, if you watch it, really speaks to the family community that we are, which is really cool. So then fast forward about 6-8 weeks later, we were able to open up the big golf course, and Tiger was there along with a PGA Tour Hall of Famer named Mark O'Meara, who's a Houstonite, who's a great ambassador, and then a crazy Irishman named David Faraday, who's famous in the golf world. And the three of those folks really commemorated and kicked us off the right way. And Tiger was able to play a few holes the first time he's been able to play a few holes in a while with his back getting healthier, and hit some wonderful shots. And we got to see him play the golf course. And it was really special. You know, it was a celebration for us. We didn't view it as the end of anything. It was more like the start of the next chapter. And now where do we go? So it's been great. He's been a wonderful design partner, both in what he's been able to do from us from a marketing standpoint, and the quality of the design is really fantastic.
And as you say that, here we are at the end of the year. Sounds like a lot of exciting things. As we look at 2017, it's all you talk about, a blank canvas as far as the development goes, but here we are approaching 2017, and that blank canvas that lies ahead for us. Tell us about Blue Jack National and some of the things that you're going to be doing next year and
sure.
as we approach this new year.
Yeah, I think one of the most exciting things and really one of the reasons that we're here today is that we're starting to now build people's primary homes, and Morningstar is in the middle of building our first, you know, long-term resident, primary residential home there. It's a gorgeous house that Ted will talk about a little bit more, but it's exciting. You're starting to see life there. We're about to start seeing kids ride bikes around the neighborhood. We're about to start seeing people walk their dogs, and those are the kind of things that we care about. You know, we're about to celebrate our first Thanksgiving there as the club being open, and we believe that we're not creating golf courses and roads and amenities. We're creating memories. That's what we're here to do, and so to see our first residential homes going up and people living in them, it's extremely exciting.
Well, thank you so much, Casey Paulson with Blue Jack National. Go to bluejacknational.com. Thanks for being on the show, Casey. And we're going to take a short break listening to Real Estate Matters with Stuart Title. Your host, Bill Napick. We're coming right back after this.
Stuart Title has been serving Texas for over 120 years. A Texas treasure, Stuart Title's longevity is a testimony to superior service, innovation, and knowing what their customers want. Recent surveys show that 92% of respondents want secure online tracking tools to help them during the closing process. Stuart Title offers the most robust and secure system to track transactions online available today. To learn more, contact Stuart Title at one of their many offices around the city. Stuart Title, online at stuart.com. That's STEWART.com.
And welcome back to the show. We now have Mr. Ted Cummings with Morningstar Builders. Ted, welcome to the show.
Good morning, Bill. Good seeing you again.
Here we are in Tomball, and it is good to see you again. If people remember, I forget the number. This is show number 145 or 144 or so. You were back, I think, on show number 45 or something, but glad to have you back. Let's tell people about Morningstar Builders.
Well, Morningstar Builders is a husband-wife owned and operated by my wife and I, and we've been in business now over 16 years, focusing in the Northwest Harris County, Southwest Montgomery County area. So Tomball, Magnolia, Woodlands is kind of where we call home and operate in that area.
So many details go into building a home. I don't know how you do it and do it so well. I've seen one of your homes not that long ago, and it is an incredible work of art that people get to live in.
You say that to all the builders. Come on, Bill.
This is the first time.
Well, we do focus on the details. That is something that we're very proud of. We're a full design build. So what that looks like, that clients may find a lot, or they may come to us looking to help them find a lot. And we're going to segue here in a little bit. We just talked about Blue Jack, and that's one of the areas that we're building, and we'll talk more about that. But they may come to us and say, we're looking for a place. We're not sure where we want to build. So we kind of help them walk through the process of lot selection. And then we also involved in the design. So we're a full design build, so helping people design the plan and then go to budget and then build the house.
And as people are listening, let's tell them the website in case they want to go to it right now as we talk.
Yes, if you'll just go to homesbymorningstar.com.
homesbymorningstar.com. Also, yes, tell us about your relationship with Blue Jack National.
Well, when we first, actually my wife Yvonne was on the board of the Tomball Chamber of Commerce, I think, when we first got word that Blue Jack was a possibility coming into the area, and heard that the course would be designed by Tiger. And even though I'm not a golfer, I can appreciate the level of quality and stuff that that would bring. And we read about the developing team. We got very excited. So we reached out to the Blue Jack team and said, what's the real estate opportunity is going to look like? And so we were able to get with them and start having that conversation of maybe being one of the builders in their community.
That's very exciting. Also, so tell us about what's going to be happening. You have a home that's going to be a feature home or a focus home coming up in 2017. Let's talk a little bit about that home.
Yes, about 5 years ago, we joined the Southern Living Custom Builder Group. If those audience out there are familiar with Southern Living Magazine, they'll find out that there's a custom builder group that's associated with the magazine, and we're in that program. And so what that allows us to do is when we do a very special home, we can have a tour in the home, and we refer to it as a custom builder showcase home through Southern Living. And so we're going to be doing that next fall of 17, and it'll be the home that's under construction right now in Blue Jack.
And it would seem to me, as you have all the homes have a certain amount of pressure, and I'm sure you try to outdo whatever you did last, like any artist or even any builder. The having a feature home like this sounds like there's even more pressure. How do you sort out the details to where you really want to make this special? What are the things that you look at as a builder to take it to say that next level? What ideas come into play?
Well, great question. The thing that excited us about this particular home is when we saw the architectural style that Blue Jack was looking for, I got very excited because it really is a different product line. It looks a little bit more kind of a, I would say, Georgia, Carolinas, you know, that part of the country would see more of a kind of a southern design. And so we actually went to Southern Living and looked at some of their previous homes that they've done and had in their collection design categories. And so we picked out what's referred to as the Elberton Way as kind of a base elevation and some ideas for that plan. So we tell people we Texified it because originally that house is only a little over 3,000 square feet and now it's about 65. So we kind of grew it. That's what happens in Texas, right?
Things get big in Texas, no doubt about it. Well, let's tell people some of the features that you're going to bring forth on this home.
Well, the home is going to be more traditional as it relates to it'll have siding, but we have upgraded it to Hardy Plank's premium product called Artisan, which is double the thickness of regular Hardy Plank. And it's both in a horizontal lap design and a what they call a vertical design, referred to as board and batten, along with some stone accents. It's got great porches on the front. On the back, we've got an L-shaped big old screen porch with an outdoor fireplace. We also added a casita or a guest house off the back that the client decided he wanted bigger. So it now has not one bedroom, but two bedrooms and an exercise room upstairs. So it's a total of six bedrooms and 5.5 baths. We worked with GAF, who's one of the major shingle manufacturers, using a brand new product line that's brand new on the marketplace called Glenwood. It's a really unique shingle pattern design. And we're going to be putting some new products in it, one of which I just saw for the first time just 2 weeks ago.
As a builder, you hear feedback all the time as you have a home that's been built. People talk about it during construction. I'm sure people say, hey, well, can we do this? Can we make this room bigger, this feature? But what are the trends that you see? You have the advantage that you probably see the trends before most people do. What are the trends that people ask you for and the things that are happening in the building world, Ted?
Yes, I would say that we're certainly seeing a trend towards what we refer to as a service kitchen. So a service kitchen is additional kitchen appliances in addition to your pantry space. So that room might be a little bit bigger, but it supports a secondary fridge, maybe secondary dishwasher, sink, and along with your pantry items. So for catering, it's wonderful. For just overflow, it's great. Thanksgiving parties, if you have it catered and have somebody come out and do some catering for you, they can set up in that service kitchen and then feed, because it's typically very close or right behind the existing kitchen. So the service kitchen has become very popular. We're doing more and more and more of those. Our Southern Living product that we're doing in Blue Jack, it has a service kitchen. And then another one that Cindy will talk about more is we call a wet room in the master bath. You have one of those at your house, right?
I do not.
Well, come on, Bill.
No. Special features. I mean, people, that's the thing about homes. I notice when I visit a home, a model home of any kind, it's interesting. I look for ideas, and I know other people do. And it's just exciting to see the new things on a new home that are being done. And, I mean, that must be a blast for you.
It is. We have a passion for design. We're known for that. We've won quite a few awards over the years. And that's really what gets us excited with our company, is to be able to do some things people haven't seen before.
Also, the outdoor living space. I think the home that I saw of yours last had a lot of things. The things I remember, it's been a while. Certainly had a barn, I believe. There were horses on the property. And your outdoor space, the patio was super incredible. Mm-hmm. You know the home I'm talking about.
Yes, and we're doing more and more against that trend is screened-in porches. We've done mosquito control systems for years, and those work okay. But ultimately, the screened-in porch really gives you the most usable year-round protection from those little creepy things that want to get on you. So, and we're doing air conditioning systems, separate air conditioning systems on the back porch. We're doing outdoor fireplaces, wood ceilings, flooring, cooking centers, TVs. You know, there's not much we're not doing on back porches. And I think those are amenities that people are looking for, regardless of whether you're spending $200,000 on a house or $1.2 on a house.
And other than the home that we're talking about that's going to be at Blue Jack National, tell us some of the other things that you're doing in 2017, getting ready to do in the new year.
Well, we've got several new projects in design, and that's my biggest part of my company is I'm involved on the design side of it, and then my construction managers are actually building the homes. But we've got four in design right now, and and different little communities around the Tomball area. But this Blue Jack is just a special place, and we're very excited to be able to partner up with Casey and his team. He mentioned the golf course and the beauty, but really until you see it, you really can't envision it.
Well, you're not a golfer now, but maybe by the end of the year you will be, and maybe I will be too.
Well, we may have to go together. That'd be quite a foursome, wouldn't it? We have to find two good people to go with us.
Exactly. Also, say, Ted, with the last minute or so, what else would you like people to know?
Well, we just appreciate the opportunity to hook up with Stewart Title. We've been a partner of theirs for literally since day one, so I think we've been with them for 16 years, so a long partnership. They do a great job for us. Strongly recommend using Stewart Title as their needs. And just an opportunity to just share people about Blue Jack and our company. We have a good reputation. We're a small builder. We're not focused on volume. We're focused on a relationship.
Again, Ted, how can people reach you?
Yes, the best way to go to homesbymorningstar.com. We have a great website, a lot of great photography of people enjoy seeing houses and some new ideas.
homesbymorningstar.com. Thank you for being on the show, Ted. And now, take another short break. Stay with us. We're coming right back on Real Estate Matters with Stewart Title.
Most people don't know that Stewart offers business, home, and auto insurance. In fact, Stewart Insurance and Risk Management has been doing that and more for over 10 years. And they partner with many leading insurance companies to offer great rates. They're a national insurance agency operating in all 50 states, delivering a broad range of insurance products. Whether you need a home insurance quote for a client's home closing or your own insurance needs, you can count on them. Call 866-845-4676. That's 866-845-4676. Stewart Insurance and Risk Management is here to help.
And welcome back to the show. We are going to talk to an interior designer. She is Cindy Applinalp Yates. Cindy, tell us about your company and welcome to the show.
Well, thanks. I'm so happy to be here. Well, my company is Chairman Design Group, and if we had a tagline, I would say we create exceptional interiors for exceptional people. We're a really passionate group about interior design. We like to start at the very beginning and work with the client all the way through to completion.
Such important work, too, because it's so important to feel good in our homes at the end of the day, or even some people that work from home. Having a home that's exciting to be in and comfortable, it's so important, and I think a lot of people miss out on that.
It's really a haven. It's really your shelter from the world. And I'm kind of uniquely qualified. I raised a large family. I raised six kids. I didn't have six kids, but I raised six kids. So I know what it's like to live in a space, how much room you need for laundry, how much room you need for passage spaces, how to really connect with conversation and have intimacy in your home. Also, having your home open for groups of people as well as intimacy within your own family. So those are a lot of the kinds of things that we try to build into our designs.
And that's right, because you have to look at whether someone's a single person living there or a couple. And as you said, that's incredible, six children to raise. And how do you stay so calm?
Well, they're all raised now, so we're good with that.
There you go.
I'm done with that, but I learned lots and lots of things.
Well, and also, I would think in any home, but certainly where you're incorporating a family that size, efficiency and everything has to be in its place, and there has to be systems involved, too, as well as the design.
Absolutely. Having a thing for clutter, like how you live in a house, how you get out the door in the morning with your kids and your backpacks and where all their sporting equipment goes and how you handle the day-to-day of life. One of the things that's happening in this Southern Living House that happens in a lot of homes now is the service kitchen that Ted mentioned, which is just super. This is a really open footprint, and so the kitchen and the eating area, the dining room, and the family room are all kind of together. So the things of life that you leave out, like your blender and your toaster and your coffee maker, those things are easily packed away in that service kitchen or super pantry, which adds to the point of your home being clutter-free. It also gives you a sense of peace and calm. So those are kinds of things that we try to build into each of our spaces.
And give us an idea, as an interior designer, we think about the home that Ted was talking about that's being built, and you are going to be on that project. When do you begin working on something like that, and how do you stay with it all along until completion?
So we started on this project about a year ago, and we were really building in the things that it embodied Southern Living. So that would be hospitality, that would be just Southern comfort Southern friendliness, being very open, warm, welcoming. Those are kinds of things that we built into this home with its beautiful porches and the kinds of materials that we are using. And then we met the homeowner. And so that kind of changed how we approached this. One of the things was, even though 6,500 square feet doesn't seem like a small footprint, we really wanted to make the whole home usable to them. So one of the things that we did with the dining room is we turned the dining room into a conversation room. It's a room that doesn't have a TV. You know, imagine that. The way that we've set up the furniture is that it's in a radial pattern, so people are really in close proximity to be able to have a conversation and to not be basically lose the moment of being together in community with each other. We took away one of the powder bathrooms and turned it into a wine room because that was really great for that homeowner. So again, those are the kinds of things that we try to build into our spaces.
When you said the word usable space, that made me think of anybody's home, including mine. Along the way, no matter what the size, I would think there are spaces we don't use. I have a 2,500 square foot home. I have a room, well, I guess I use it as storage, but there's a lot of things that aren't being used as efficiently as they could be. So that's so important to have that usable space.
We really try to look at that for the client and how they're living in the space, whether it's an exercise room, a craft room. A lot of times I try to do a space where you can leave a big mess out too, like for somebody who scrapbooks or sews or makes jewelry or does something so that they have a private space where they don't have to clean it up. It's not on their dining room table. So those are the kinds of things that we try to build into our interiors.
Even like an artist, I'm picturing someone with a canvas out or drawings or things like that.
Yes, absolutely. This Blue Jack home has a really cute addition. It's a little barn that's kind of in the front, and I'm probably going to use it as for their golf carts, but I would love for that to be an artist studio or a little kind of she shed kind of thing, because, you know, there's a man cave, and then the place to create for a woman, I think, would be really great.
I also would think, as an interior designer, when you see a home, whether it's something like this in progress, something new, or a client enlists you to work on their home, you see things with a different eye. You see them as an interior designer. So let's say you're visiting a friend or something, and you just go to a home. What are the things that go through your mind as a designer?
Mostly what I appreciate about the home. You know, the beauty of it, the architecture. I look at how it's serving the client. I also look for things that aren't working, like pinch points, like going back to my idea of having raised a big family. The pinch points would be things that hallways are too narrow, or there's clutter left out, like the things that are always left out by the front door. Okay, so how can we solve that problem? Because I think interior design is really problem solving in a person's personal space.
Well, let me ask you, what is the one common mistake a person would make in designing a room?
Ooh, that's a tough one.
Is it clutter?
It's probably clutter and not having enough places to put things. The other common mistake that people make is having too much stuff. So I honestly think that people should only have the things around them that have purpose and meaning, that are beautiful to them or provide some kind of service. And, you know, to have own your stuff, not have your stuff own you. So that's a lot of times when people have too many things, that's my take on it.
Like in the book, The Life-Changing Art of Tidying
yes.
Up by Marie Kondo. Have you
yes,
read that?
Yes, I have. And I've also read Spark Joy. I thought, and that really made a big impact on me.
It's amazing that book, it's been out, I think, over a year, maybe 2 years. It still hovers in that top seven of the New York Times bestseller. It's incredible. It shows that we have too much stuff.
Right, yeah, right, absolutely. Another thing in interior design, a lot of times in places that are hectic, like a kitchen can be hectic and cluttery, we try to use symmetry because symmetry is automatically calming. Same thing in a master bath. And having places to put your things. One of the things that you're going to find in this home is really beautiful cabinetry and millwork, very high attention to detail as far as tile, lighting, cabinetry, all those kinds of creature comforts that really support the lifestyle of this family and just make this home soothing and beautiful from the ground up.
Cindy, let's tell people you work in Houston, but you are all around the Houston area. To give them an idea of the scope of your work, where you will go, where you won't go.
We'll go almost anywhere in Houston, try to stay in the Houston Metroplex, and I love going to Montgomery and out to Blue Jack, which is absolutely a beautiful place. I feel like I go on vacation every time I get to go there, so don't mind going north either.
And if someone can't or is not ready to use your services yet, but they're listening and they say, well, wonder if she'll give me an idea what I can do to help myself, to help my own home. What's the first thing you tell someone if they're looking at their living room, let's say, and it's just not quite right? What should they do?
Honestly, the best thing that I've ever read, which I do periodically, is take all the furniture and stuff out of your house and then only bring back in what's important to you. So that way you really get rid of clutter and you really reorganize it and pay attention to how you want to use your things. And the other thing is give yourself a breather from media and technology to where you can really just communicate with your family or those that are in your life. I think we're all too busy, and I think that's good advice.
I think that's great advice. Also, I would ask, you make me think of this. If someone is asking you to help them with their living room, kitchen, or whatever, is it better, let's take to the living room, is it better to have the room empty or to see their stuff as it is, or does it matter?
I want to see their stuff as it is. And then ask them what's working and what's not working.
Excellent. Let's tell people how they can reach you, Cindy.
You can reach us at Chairma. chairma.com, and we'd love to hear from you.
Excellent. Thank you, Cindy Applin Alp Yates, interior designer. Go to chairma.com. Thanks, Cindy. And we're going to take a short break. Come back. We're coming back with even more. Stay with us.
Stewart Title has been serving Texas for over 120 years. A Texas treasure, Stewart Title's longevity is a testimony to superior service, innovation, and knowing what their customers want. Recent surveys show that 92% of respondents want secure online tracking tools to help them during the closing process. Stewart Title offers the most robust and secure system to track transactions online available today. To learn more, contact Stewart Title at one of their many offices around the city. Stewart Title, online at stewart.com. That's STEWART.com.
And welcome back to the show, Real Estate Matters with Stewart Title. Stewart Title, we have offices all over Houston, 30-some locations, and we are around the United States. In fact, we are an international company traded on the New York Stock Exchange. That is right. And today, we are on the road in Tomball, Texas, and we have a terrific office right here in Tomball, where we are stewards of your real estate transaction all the time. In fact, we have one of the A-team escrow officers in our whole organization. She's the vice president. Her name is Jane Matthews, right here in Stewart. Tomball, welcome to the show, Jane.
Thank you, Bill. Thanks for coming out and visiting us today.
It is exciting because, seriously, I have heard so much about this office through our vice president, Betty Warren, and it's just exciting to be here and see it in real life.
We have a family here in Tomball, and I think it shows. Most of our employees have been here over a decade. They've all been here over 5 years. So we really feel like a family here, and that's the environment we want our customers to feel when they walk in the door.
And they feel comfortable as soon as they get here. I did. I pulled up. You didn't know who I was. I felt, hey, this is awesome.
We have the best, I'm not going to call her receptionist. She is Stewart Title Tomball, the way she welcomes, because she is the face that you see when you walk in the door, and she does a great job making people feel at home.
And that's so important in a real estate transaction. And each one, I guess, has been told like a fingerprint. Each one is different. Some might be more complicated than others, but so many things come together, and you get to see it firsthand because you're behind the scenes. You help put all these components together, but you have someone buying a home, selling a home, the real estate professional. So everyone's there for a different reason. And when it comes together, there must be a tremendous feeling of satisfaction on your end.
That's one of the important jobs, is for us to never forget that while it's a transaction, it represents a lot more than that to the buyers and sellers, because a purchase or a sale of a home is probably the most financial resources of the people in the room that we're dealing with.
It really is. And of course, real estate, whether it's the home they're going to live in, like this beautiful Morningstar home that's being built, or even if it's an investor, real estate is tied to the American dream. So it really is, when you think about how it all comes together, it really is fascinating. And as an escrow officer, how do you stay organized with all the things that you have to do? Because it really can be complex.
It can be very complex at times. If it wasn't complex, I don't think it would be as interesting and as fun as I still find it after all these years. I don't get bored doing my job. People think I do the same thing over and over, but I don't do the same things over and over. Every transaction is unique because of the needs of people, and we try to meet those needs.
And also, you have the wonderful Sandy Reese developing business here for so many years. She does an incredible job, and she did a great job of assembling this fine cast of characters, right?
Our Northwest office out here has just blossomed. When we began, it was a very small team, and now we have 10 employees that are trying to keep up with the business, and she's done a great job.
Well, very nice. Jane, would you tell people how they can reach you if they want to close their next transaction? And I know they do right here.
The best way to reach me is via email at jane.matthews@stewart.com. We also have a website that's stewarthouston.com, where you can look at all the Stewart Houston offices, and it has contact information from there.
Excellent. Ladies and gentlemen, Jane Matthews, the A-Team, right here at Stewart Title. Tom Ball, thank you, Jane, for being on the show, and we are going to take another short break on Real Estate Matters with Stewart Title. Your host, Bill Nampick. Stay with us. There's even more.
If you've been in the real estate industry for any length of time, you know unexpected and costly events can happen. Safeguard yourself against the unexpected with Real Estate Errors and Omissions Insurance, or E&O, through Stewart Insurance and Risk Management. Not all E&O insurance policies are created equal. How confident are you that your current E&O policy fully protects you? Stewart Insurance and Risk Management offers expertise in the real estate industry and tailors your coverage to correctly manage your risk. With Stewart Insurance and Risk Management, facing the unexpected just became a lot easier. Safeguard your future with Real Estate E&O Insurance through Stewart Insurance and Risk Management. Call today at 866-845-4676. That's 866-845-4676. Or email us at stewartinsurance@stewart.com to request tailored insurance options for you and your business.
And welcome to the show, Michelle Steffen with Stewart Insurance and Risk Management. Michelle, how are you?
Good. How are you, Bill?
As always, it's great to see you. And boy, let's tell people Stewart Insurance and Risk Management, all kinds of insurance, Stewart.com, right?
Absolutely. Absolutely. And we also have our Facebook page. They could go and visit. We have Twitter, Instagram, several different methods to learn about us and who we are.
And no doubt about it, Stewart.com, front page, personal and commercial insurance, and in the line and category of personal insurance, mm-hmm. one of the most important things is our home, right?
Absolutely. It's the biggest investment for most people. So when you take the steps towards home ownership, you are taking on potential risks to yourself financially if you're not properly insured. So what we do really is focus on insuring people properly better than everybody else.
That's right. Well, let's tell people some of the basics and things that they should think about when they think about insuring their home.
So you have your dwelling coverage, which covers the structure. You've got your personal property, which is everything inside the home. And then you have your liability. Those are the three pillars, if you will, of homeowners insurance, the three things that you should focus on. Replacement cost is built into that dwelling coverage. And then again, liability, which is covers you in the event you're called into a claimant situation for bodily injury or property damage somebody believes you caused. So as an example, somebody's injured at your home. Right? It's maybe
there's a party or something, right?
Exactly.
You have a guest over
exactly.
or guests.
And your medical payments will kick in up to $5,000. Typically, $5,000 is the standard to protect you against that. Anything in excess of that, then you would go to your liability coverage, which the standard is $300,000 to $500,000.
Well, Michelle, a lot of times people handle their home insurance. Not everyone, but a lot of times they get the renewal bill in the mail. And they just say, okay, it's gone up a little bit this year. They pay it. They go down the road. Really, they should take care and look and also talk to someone that does this every
Absolutely.
Day like you, the professionals at Stewart Insurance and Risk Management.
Exactly. And, you know, honestly, Bill, we focus so much on educating the customer. It's kind of one of the pillars of who we are. You know, again, our agents are all very talented. They know the product. They know the carriers. They know potential risks. And then they can evaluate each customer experience and walk them through it. So the goal is to always be educating and take advantage of opportunities to bring the consumer in and explain something that they didn't know, teach them how they can more properly insure themselves with the products that we offer.
And that is so easily done, simply by calling Stewart Insurance and Risk Management, and they can talk to someone, and you can go over the policy with them and the potential policies and coverages they need, right?
Every day.
Let's tell them how to do that. We do it every day. All day long.
You can reach us at 866-845-4676. Again, 866-845-4676.
And also, let's tell people that at your company, you have a choice of carriers for the insurance, so you're not locked into one particular carrier, so you can actually design the package and tune into their exact needs, right?
Exactly. And that's part of the process with our licensed agents who handle these incoming requests. They will go through extensive questioning to dig down deeper to what the risk is and then find solutions for them. We're an independent insurance agency, which means we work with over 30 different carriers in Texas alone. So we essentially figure out what the risk is and then find a good place for it based on each individual customer need.
And a minute ago, I talked about how people get their renewal notices for whatever kind of insurance in the mail once a year, once every 6 months. And I always think it's a good idea. Don't wait for that renewal, because things throughout the year for your home certainly will change. They could change. And it's probably a good time to, before you get that renewal, to sit down with someone at Stewart Insurance and Risk Management and actually talk about it then and get ready. And if they have to cancel that policy, that's not a big deal.
Absolutely. I mean, honestly, we have what we call the Stewart Renewal Review. So we actively work with our customers at each renewal to make sure that if things did change throughout the year, that we're evaluating that at the renewal. If folks want to call, I absolutely encourage it. We'll be more than happy to walk them through that same process. But if you feel like you have evaluated at length, at the renewal period, then contact us when your renewal comes up. We're going to be here, and we're happy to do it at their convenience.
Also, you mentioned the term replacement coverage. Let's tell us a little bit more about that.
Okay, so there's a huge difference between market value, replacement costs, and actual cash value, which is similar to market or appraisal value. Those three things are very different. And when we have new home buyers who are new to purchasing homes, we have to explain it constantly that what it costs to rebuild your home for like, kind, and value is very different from what you would. Be able to purchase it or sell it for on the market. And then the appraisal value is for tax purposes only. And again, it's usually very different from replacement costs. So when you go through the process of evaluating your coverage, it's so important to get down to the nitty-gritty and really make sure that that replacement cost is enough. So at claim time, you're not left holding a $50,000 invoice.
Exactly. And I'm thinking about, there are questions, just as we're exploring the basics of home insurance, there are questions that people don't even know to ask, and that's why it's so important to talk to a professional at Stewart Insurance and Risk Management.
Exactly. And again, you know, it's like this in every state, specifically in Texas where we're located. Every policy is so very different that if you don't have a seasoned professional to look at it with you, then chances are you could miss something. And there's so many nuances built into a policy that most people don't even consider.
Indeed. As we talk about dwelling, we talked about home ownership, home insurance, but what about the person that's out there that maybe sold their home in the interim, they're renting, or they didn't buy their first house yet and they're renting? Let's tell people what they can do as they rent properties and or an apartment.
Absolutely. So there's a renter's policy, which is specific to a tenant type risk. So if you're renting a home or an apartment or a condo, even if you're the tenant and there's a landlord, this is going to cover your personal property. Just because the landlord has coverage on the structure does not mean that you're properly covered. So if you have a claim. Let's use fire as an example. That's the very first type of peril or cause of loss. If you have a fire loss in an apartment unit and all of your belongings are burned or damaged by smoke, there's absolutely no coverage for that under the landlord's policy. So you would want your own personal contents policy, and that's what a renter's policy is.
Very nice. Also, another thing that comes to mind as we think about people in the real estate profession, they sell their home, they go to the next property, maybe the home is still listed for sale, there are no belongings in the home. So there's a special kind of coverage, right, for that vacant home. And the standard home policy doesn't cover the home when it's vacant. Tell us a quick word on that before we
Absolutely.
Conclude.
So most home policies have a clause that relates to vacant exposure. So if the home has been vacant for over 30 days, which is typical, it becomes an issue at claim time as to whether or not that home was properly protected from that loss. So the market has developed a vacancy policy that gives you back that coverage in the time that the home is vacant. So the most likely claim during vacancy situations are water damage losses, because nobody's there to shut the water off. So just little things like that that you may not
little
consider
things
on
are
home
big pol- things, aren't they?
Exactly. Little things are big things. So certainly consider that if your home is going to be vacant over 30 days, you need to evaluate the coverage and make sure it's what you need.
Thank you so much, Michelle Steffen, Stewart Insurance and Risk Management. Thank you, Michelle.
Thanks, Bill.
Stewart Title has been serving Texas for over 120 years. A Texas treasure, Stewart Title's longevity is a testimony to superior service, innovation, and knowing what their customers want. Recent surveys show that 92% of respondents want secure online tracking tools to help them during the closing process. Stewart Title offers the most robust and secure system to track transactions online available today. To learn more, contact Stewart Title at one of their many offices around the city. Stewart Title, online at stewart.com. That's S-T-E-W-A-R-T.com.
And welcome back, Real Estate Matters with Stewart Title. We've assembled the crew. Now we only have two microphones. We're going to see how this works. Welcome back. First of all, here is Casey Paulson. Casey, welcome back. He's with Blue Jack National.
Yes, thanks for having me back. I know one of the questions we wanted to discuss was how we came up with the name Blue Jack, and to let everybody know, it's the name of a species of oak tree, similar to a live oak. It comes from And I guess the joke or the part of that that people would want to know is that we were told that there were hundreds and hundreds on property. And to date, after 3 years, we found one. And so that's probably the biggest challenge we've had is finding more bluejack oak trees. But
I don't know about the listeners, but one of the things I'm going to do after the show is look up what a bluejack oak tree looks like. I didn't know. I guess like anything else, there are so many varieties of trees in the family of the oak tree.
Yeah, there are tons. And the unique thing about the bluejack oak is it doesn't lose its leaves in the winter. So it's a deciduous tree, but it holds on to its leaves for as long as it can.
Well, that sounds exciting. Well, Casey, tell us, what else should we know about Bluejack National here as we're ending the year, starting next year? Can't wait to see it.
Yeah, I think the most important thing to realize is that folks who live in downtown Houston, they can have a uniquely different life experience that's less than an hour away. They don't have to drive very far. They can still make their weekend commute. They can still have this whole other life that they cannot have in downtown Houston that's really an hour away, and get away and enjoy their family.
And as I'm thinking about this, it probably might be a good idea. People a lot of times have the weekend home, the chill-out home, whatever you want to call it, but it sounds like it's close enough where someone doesn't have to go to Brenham or some kind of way far-out place. They could have their city home, like I do, and then have a place that's not that far where it's resort kind of living.
Yeah, you're absolutely correct. I think there's a second home component, and then like what we're able to be doing with Ted and Yvonne, it's going to be a wonderful, wonderful primary place for people to live as well.
No law against having two homes, is there?
No, it's encouraged, actually.
In fact, that sounds great. Also,
BlueJackNational.com, a very thorough spot that'll show you everything that we're all about.
And also, Ted Cummins, he is with Morningstar Builders. Tell us how you met Ted, or what happened first there, just out of curiosity.
You know, we got to meet Ted and Yvonne. We were looking for just a very small amount of select partners, and we met and immediately hit it off. You know, I think our attention to detail matched theirs, and their commitment to creating a product that fits in our environment was—it's been great. It's been a very wonderful partnership.
It's
so
exciting
far.
When the relationships build, and when they're so successful along the way, and then when everything's finished, is even better. Ted, tell us what else we should know about what's going on with the home that's coming up here in 2017, or whatever else you would like people to know.
Well, again, we encourage our listeners and readers of our blog to be on tune of our website so they can stay in touch with what's going on during the construction phase. Right now we're in framing and getting ready to do HVAC and insulation soon. So the house is under progress. We'll be having some photographs, maybe some videos that we'll be shooting of the house that's under construction. For those that want to follow that house as it's under construction, they might enjoy that.
That sounds great. Also, you have a lot of other homes that have already been built. Tell people how they can learn more about those.
Well, again, they can go to our website. We've got a great photo gallery. One thing that we have done as an organization is I have 100% photography that's only done professionally. And I would tell other builders out there, oops, I'm giving away my secret, aren't I? My marketing secret. But we spent money on good photographs, and our website shows. So they can see some quality homes that are built in this area for over 16 years on our website.
You mentioned quality photography. To me, that's just logical, and it's a given with a home of any price, but certainly as you get into the higher pricing. But every once in a while, I look at real estate in other cities, and recently I've been looking in Pennsylvania, and I look at some of the real estate photography. It is so poor that it just shows you must have great pictures, and I don't know what the market's like in this particular place, but it's incredible how people put poor photographs up there.
Yeah, it is kind of amazing, but you know, when you have a good product, and then working with Cindy on the design standpoint of staging, if we build a spec house, we'll stage it, and it just photographs even better if it's got furnishing in it.
And Ted, if you would, you're talking about giving away your secrets. We'll ask you to give away one more at this time. Whether someone's in the real estate world, I think as a builder, as I mentioned before, you do so many things and put so many components and details from permitting, from dealing with construction, all those things. But just as a professional, how do you stay organized for anybody in any business? Give them something that you've learned along the way that's been a core principle of your success.
Well, we have a company of established core values, and it's very important that we keep those core values with our team. We communicate well. We want to make sure that our team members are doing what they do best. So if we find out something that is on their plate that really is not wanted to be on their plate, we try to move it to somebody else that they can handle that and work on that well. Communication, we use a web-based software program for our scheduling, communication of change orders, and just staying on top of things, making sure the homeowner is aware of what's going on. For some reason, nobody likes surprises.
You go figure, hey? Communication is so important. Once again, Ted, tell people the website.
Yes, we're at homesbymorningstar.com.
And now let's talk a little bit more about interior design with Cindy Aplin-Alp Yates. Cindy, welcome back.
Hey, glad to be back.
Well, tell us now. I know that you never cover everything in a radio show of this time frame. So some of the other things, though, you've had some other things that you wanted to mention. So let's tell people right now.
Well, what I wanted to say also is that this is the third Southern Living project we've been involved in as a showcase house with Morningstar Builders. And we've done lots of projects together, and I couldn't be happier to be connected with such a great build design team, who's really forward-thinking and super passionate about their craft, and just builds a beautiful, beautiful home. We also have a Pinterest page set up for this home, so if you want some sneak peeks of what's actually going in it as it relates to lighting and plumbing and cabinetry and just the overall mood and feel of this space, I would invite you to our website to get to that page on Pinterest, and our website is just chairma.com.
And also, as we're sharing success tips, tell us, as you try to stay organized and you're dealing with art, symmetry, things that that are so important to making our homes enjoyable. What are some of the things that you do as on a regular basis that you have learned is your as far as core principles of success?
I think that we look at the intention of the client, and that is always at the forefront of our designs. What is it for them? It's not about us. It's about that client. So really anchoring into that, and that's the mantra every project that we accept. We see how we can really help that family and have their home life and their home space really support their intentions. And that's been, if I could say one thing that's been the key to our success, it's really putting others before us, ourselves. And the way that we stay organized on that is we have a budget, and it's our marching orders as to what we do in a client space. So it's very prepared. We space plan, we do a budget, and then we execute on that budget. So clients get a beautifully completed home within budget in a time frame that is all agreed upon.
And in the world of interior design, I'm thinking furniture changes all the time, new colors come out, building ideas are happening all the time. How do you stay on top of some of the new things and trends that take place in interior design? Because there are trends that happen, right?
Oh, yeah. We go to market 4 times a year. I just got back from the High Point Furniture Market, so I see all the latest and greatest in new things. And what's really been interesting in that, Bill, is that there's not really a trend. It's what a client likes. And there's all kinds of beauty in different design genres, whether it's transitional or contemporary or more traditional. I'm seeing lighter wood tones coming back, so I think that's going to be around to stay for a good long while. I'm also seeing things like in finishes for hardware, more gold tones, warm tones, less on the silvery tones. But honestly, I think a person should be true to themselves, and what you like is what should go in your home, and just completely avoid the trends. We also go to builder shows. We do that twice a year. So we're really involved in the building community. We're part of the Greater Houston Builders Association. And so we design a lot of things, but we don't build anything. So we really, really need our building partners and our title companies, and you know, all this works together. It's really a team lift. And that's really what's the most probably enchanting part about this job is how we're all have a common goal, and it's really fun to be involved in.
As they say, I say it almost every show, it takes teamwork to make the dream work, and without the right team, it can be a nightmare. One last thing I'm thinking about, Cindy, about flooring. Are there trends in flooring? And let's say someone uses, I like wood floors, but what is there a tone in the wood floor that's more popular now, or I don't know, dark, light, in between? What do you think?
I think you're going to see lighter things. Lighter things are coming back, and things with less sheen, more of a matte finish. That goes to a lifestyle thing too, Bill. Like, do you have a dog? Do you like to sweep your floors often? If you have a lighter floor, it shows less dust.
Good word, and we'll end on that note. You have been listening to Real Estate Matters with Stuart Title, your host, Bill Nampe. Oh, yeah. Check us out at Stuart.com. You can hear the show 24/7. All the episodes are there, all 144, Stuart.com/Houston. If you would like to see these guests, if you're listening at the time of broadcast, go to my YouTube channel. That is Bill Nappick Radio Shows. You can see all these great guests right here on location in the beautiful Stuart Title office in Tomball, Texas. Bill Nappick. That's with a K. K-N-A-P-I-K. Bill Nappick Radio Shows. Check us out on YouTube or Stuart.com/Houston. Until next week, thanks for listening.